Florida Republicans and Marco Rubio said Wednesday that the monumental bipartisan U.S.-China trade agreement enacted over 20 years ago set the stage for today's economic pitfalls. The China Relations Act of 2000 allowed China to become a permanent member of the World Trade Organization, WTO, and opened China's market up globally. But Rubio argued the flawed bipartisan consensus was a critical mistake that tripled the U.S. trade deficit within 5 years, eliminated tens of thousands of American factories and cost U.S. workers an estimated 2.5 billion jobs. This loss has contributed to historic declines in men's labor force participation, wages and even marriage in the United States, Rubio said speaking from an event at the Hillsdale College Kirby Center in Washington, D.C., Wednesday. And an American dream, sadly, far too many Americans have come to believe is no longer in reach for people like them, he added. Rubio said the deal, which was expected to promote democratic values and an open and fair market and help reduce cost for the American consumer, has become a geopolitical disaster. 20 years ago, when you admit China to the World Trade Organization, what you're basically saying is that this is a country that follows a certain set of rules, Rubio told Fox News. Who know they didn't, who should have known they wouldn't. Rubio argued China's ability to cheat the system has made the Chinese Communist Party, CCP, has been able to extend its reach globally and bolster its economy while the US has taken economic hits. They are able to subsidize their companies. They are able to barter companies from doing business there, but their companies get to do whatever they want here, he continued. The Florida Republican side when his father was a banquet bartender in 1985, the cost of thriving index produced by Oren has found that just 30 work weeks were needed for the median male worker to afford a year's worth of basics to raise a family. Today, that some index indicates it would take 53 weeks in a 52-week year to do the same, Rubio explained. The senator argued that some of the most complex economic struggle the U.S. has experienced over the last decade are a direct result of China's admittance into the WTO. Cities and counties, and their communities hollowed out by the loss of these jobs, these factories dependent on China. Why do we have a supply hanglut? Because most of the things we buy these days are made somewhere else. If they were being made in America, or at least being made in the Dominican Republic or Central America, would be a lot easier to get those things here. But admittance to the WTO opened it up, he added. Lawmakers on both sides of the aisle have increasingly pushed to expand the US manufacturing market to bring job status and reduce the stranglehold on American companies. But Rubio said reducing reliance on the Chinese market will require a generational overhaul on consumer expectations. To succeed it must be the work of an entire generation and cross the entire political spectrum. It must become more new consensus, he concluded.